everyone, welcome to another Make a Card Monday. This week I'm going to start with a craft card base, which is no surprise to any of you who know me. I love craft, and I use it probably entirely too much. So anyway, this is just a standard size card. So finish size is 5 1/2 by 4 1/4. I'm also going to be using this little frame. This is from Card Frames and Sentiments, and this is my very first digital kit, and it's available over at twopeasinabucket.com, and I'll have a link in the sidebar if you're over at YouTube, or if you're at my blog, I'll have it, you know, there as well, so if you want to go and grab that. And I'm just going to cut around the edges really carefully. And this is just a PNG or ping image that I just printed out straight from Word. You don't have to have like Photoshop or any special program to open these files if you're just gonna, you know, print them out the way they are. If you wanted to add things on top or edit them or, you know, customize them a little bit more, you'd want a photo editing software like Photoshop or any of those out there. There, I've cut out my little frame. I'm going to take these ribbons from Stampin' Up. This is the Perfect Day ribbons. I'm just going to take out this You're So Sweet. The way I do it is I just very lightly with an X-Acto knife, because, you know, it'll cut really easily through this thin layer because it has the sheeted ribbons and then the backer sheet, and I always just cut the top out and it leaves the backer sheet intact. It's not cut all the way through. I'm going to put this off to the side. Actually, what I'm going to do is I plan to cover this little chipboard heart, and I'm going to put it like right next to it, so I want to make sure that it fits. So about right there would work. Okay. Okay, let's see if that's ready. And we're good. Okay, I'm gonna cover this chipboard heart with some paper, but you'll notice that there has these little nubbies on it, right? So we want to get rid of those. You can use scissors. I'm going to use the Basic Gray Precision Filing Set, and this is a new one. I haven't opened it yet. So there we go. And I'm just going to sand down those little marks that were left from being in the sheet. And I'm going to, I'm just going to put the glue on the heart, and then we'll set it aside to dry while I finish up some other things on the card. And press them down really good and set them aside. Okay. All right, I've got some patterned paper. This is from Cosmo Cricut. What line is it? It's their Little Man line. There's lots of papers for like a little boy. They're super cute. I got some to possibly scrapbook my nephews. Actually put that right there, and then I'm gonna put some white ribbon to pull in the white. Normally I would go for like a vanilla color, but this is actually more yellow than vanilla, and I don't have a cardstock that's that color, so I thought I would just make it white and pull in white somewhere else so that it matches a little better. So okay, so we're going to adhere that to the card. Isn't it cute? You've got these little balls on the other side. I am just in love with Cosmo Cricut paper right now. I don't know what the deal is. I just love it entirely too much. This is the matte pack from Stampin' Up, and then just a paper piercer. You can use a needle, you know, whatever you've got on hand. This is actually called an awl, AWL, I think. And if you can, you know, find one under that name, that's the same thing. think that little guy is just about dry. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to cut as close to the edge as I can. I'm eventually going to go over and sand the edges down. So and I totally forgot I was going to put ribbon on here before I put it on the card. So I'm actually going to put the ribbon on now, which will mean I will have to do a little bit of cutting on the card. Not a big deal. So I have my X-Acto knife, and I think I want it about right here. And there we go. There's this week's card. I hope you enjoyed, and I will catch you all next week. Thanks for watching.